Joining me now is Democratic Senator Ron Wyden of Oregon, a ranking member of the Finance Committee and a member of the Intelligence Committee as well. So he's able to cover multiple topics for us today. Senator Wyden, appreciate your time. Simple question. Thank you. Did Michael Flynn's son get a letter to appear before the Intelligence Committee?
I can't comment on a news story or committee deliberations, but
do you want to talk to him?
Let me give you two key points. Michael Flynn had access to our country's most sensitive secrets, and Michael Flynn was allowed to keep serving in the White House after the Justice Department had warned that he was vulnerable to blackmail. So this is a very important matter that has been raised by a news story. I can't comment on it, but I want to get to the bottom of it.
Three officials say this inquiry into Flynn is focused at least in part on his work with his father's lobbying firm, Flynn Intel Group, I think it's called, for which he traveled to Russia alongside his dad a couple years ago, 2015. Attorneys for Flynn and his father declined to comment, but the younger Flynn is tweeting about this report saying, quote, fake news media is done covering those pesky hurricanes. In his words, back to Russia, hashtag nothing burger. Bottom line here, do you see this as a nothing burger?
I certainly think this story needs to be followed up on. We've got to get the facts. Look, this is a constant refrain from those involved in the investigation. Donald Trump Jr., when there was a clear attempt to collude, basically said this was all about fake facts. So that's the pattern whenever there's a story. And my job is to get to the bottom of it and to account to the public for what happened and do it in a way that doesn't compromise classified information.
There's another major story that's been buried by so much focus on these hurricanes, and this is an important one affecting tens of millions of Americans. It's the Equifax breach exposing information on more than 143 million Americans. No one asked to be a customer of Equifax, but now about half of the American population is potentially victimized here. Specifically, what kind of accountability do you want to see? What is the solution right now?
It seems to me that this looks like the Exxon Valdez of privacy. So the first step that I've taken is I've written legislation requiring that the credit reporting agencies provide PIN-level protection to consumers for free. The companies have caused this problem. They ought to pay for it. There are a lot of unanswered questions. Orrin Hatch, the chairman of the Finance Committee, and I are concerned, for example, about these three executives where it looks like they sold stock after they learned about this major breach. So there are a lot of unanswered questions here.
So about those three in particular, what should happen to those three individuals? They sold $1.8 million in stock in early August. What should happen to those men?
I can't speculate on the various laws that may have been broken, but obviously this is once again an example, if accurate, of a double standard. You know, they're supposed to have jobs where the public can trust them. And if they, in effect, knew of the breach and then went out and sold stock so they could take care of themselves, while your reporting just said millions of Americans would suffer, that's just plain wrong and a breach of trust.
Let me ask you about one other headline, another story we're following. The Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin, as you know well, requested a government plane to take him on his honeymoon to Europe this past summer. A Treasury Department spokesperson tells NBC News that the honeymoon travel request was made to uphold security standards, stating it's imperative for the secretary to, quote, have access to secure communications, and it's our practice to consider a wide range of options to ensure he has these capabilities during his travel. What do you say about that?
If that's accurate, this is just slap your forehead kind of stuff. You don't need a big government rule book to say, look, it's just common sense not to do something like that and have hardworking taxpayers. I mean, this is a key economic official, and he's supposed to be working on getting tax relief to middle-class folks, and instead we're talking about trips like this. It's just wrong.
$25,000 an hour, we're told it would have cost to use that government plane to travel. Senator Ron Wyden, we appreciate your joining us. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.